What's up, guys? Hope everyone had an amazing week. My week was a year. It feels like it was so long. It was like the longest week I've ever had. Today was my Friday, as in it was the fifth day of the week that I worked, and I woke up feeling absolutely exhausted. I was in my bed and I even thought to myself, "Oh, thank God I can sleep in today." And then I realized it was still I still had a whole day to get through. Anyways, I wasn't the only one that was exhausted, so I got through it, and I'm now truly, physically, emotionally, everything exhausted. But I'm really excited, because I get to work on some other things that are very important to me, like my nutrition course that I'm in right now, which I'm learning so much. I've already learned so much from just like, you can learn so much. And most of what I learned is from like YouTube. Dr. Berg is an amazing resource. I literally watch everything he posts. But anyways, it's really fun to be able to use what I'm learning in real life. I love that. I love when it all connects together, and that's the goal. But anywho, yeah, today is actually a really interesting day. I woke up feeling really sad, sad and exhausted, and I wasn't quite sure why. And then my family texted me and they were like, sending love today. My youngest sister sent that, and it's because my mom passed away 10 years ago today. So today, 10 years ago, my mom passed away. And there were moments of the day when I might have shed a tear. And I'm still have processing to do, but it still feels like yesterday. Like, that's the weirdest thing. And I'm not sure if that means my grief is not healed. Like, I always wonder, like, does that mean my grief? Like, what does that mean about my grief? Am I doing something wrong? I still feel like I can still feel her. Not like, it's funny because like you don't feel her, but then there's this little inkling of you that's like, oh my God, she like. You want to know why grief is so weird? And that's why I am weird. Sorry. grief is weird. And people that might be affected by grief are weird, maybe, because you're living in a reality, like you were in a reality, a literal reality, where there was a real human being that you had a serious, deep attachment to that was like no one else. And then they disappear from your reality. And then you're expected to live every day as if because they're not, like they're not there, because they're not, right? But you completely experience this other reality when they were there. And it is extremely odd for the human mind and psyche to deal with these types of intense and seriously spiritual real life situations. And so, and then it makes it weirder because like I want to believe that my mom is an angel, you know what I mean? Like that she's there for me all the time. But then there will be moments when reality hits and it's like she's gone. You need to grieve her like she's not here. I don't know if I will ever understand this concept, but here's the thing. For the first time in my life, since my mom passed away, was able to. I work with older women, and I was able to give the love that I would have given my mom if she was here today to them. It's hard though. Like, it's really hard for me to show that side of myself for some reason because of the pain I still hold on to. And like this weird like pain, like this weird feeling of like rejection from society. Like it's ingrained in me that there's, because I've dealt with such weird things in my own brain, like that I don't know how to describe to other people, like it creates a distance between me and others, but I don't want that forever. But the truth is like it felt so good because I was talking to these people how I would have talked to my mother. And it's kind of weird though, because like I wanted to do an activity with them where they just were able to, I don't know, where they were able to express themselves fully. I don't know, with some craft. And one of them made a comment about how she was like, this, I feel like this is something I did as a little girl. And I'm like, well, I don't want to make her feel like a little girl. But then again, it's like, that's how I feel like we can all, like, women to women can connect sometimes. And maybe that's just because, I don't know, something's freaking wrong with me. And I don't know how to connect on, like, any other level. But it was really amazing because that is a way, if you're struggling with grief and similar situation as this, like you can act towards other people that might remind you of your mom even with that love that you would have given to her. And so today does mark the day that she passed, left the physical reality. But I was treating others with, I was giving her so much love to the universe, hoping that she will receive it. And that's the best I can do. And I was so exhausted today, but man, did I feel like I did connect with my mom a little bit more than I would usually. And I never really knew how to, I guess, care for her. I never really got that opportunity because when she passed away, it happened so quickly. She passed away within a matter of a year. We found out she had cancer, and then she died a year later. And it happened so fast that I was in high school. I was traumatized. I still am. But yeah. Like, no one will ever replace your mom, you know? I think sometimes I'm even like, that might be a block for me, is that I don't want to, like, but my mom wasn't even, God, it's so complicated, but, okay. Anyways, that's the two sides of me, and, yeah. Okay, so speaking of long day, I got some long socks. These I just got in the mail. They're compression socks. I've been a runner since high school, and I remember that having compression socks on, I literally ran better. I also need to get new running shoes, so yeah. But these are sick. I got them online. Pro compression. I love the color. I don't know if it's literally the like science behind the technology of the sock, if it's literally just as superficial as the color, but for whatever reason, I run better with compression socks. So yeah, got these in the mail today. I'll probably use them this weekend. Also, Element got the stamp of approval by my father. He got these in the mail today because I told him about, or I showed him my, gave him some of my packets of the Element water. And he loved it. And if it's keeping him hydrated, that's great. The only thing is, like, obviously the salt when you have already high cholesterol. Look, he's having one packet a day. And I think if it's going to help him with fasting, then it's a good thing. And it can help you retain water. And it does help you retain water. And he's not, if he were to cut out everything else from his diet that's salty, it would be perfect. So anyways, I've been seeing a ton of like ads online that are like, don't use Element anymore. Like, these cheap, first of all, Element is not cheap. It's freaking expensive. But they're like calling it cheap now, whatever. Like, saying it's a cheap electrolyte, things like this. I'll have to do more research. But yes, he got the best flavor, which is the citrus salt. And it's literally the best flavor ever. It's literally like a healthy soda that keeps you hydrated instead of dehydrating you. Love that. Yeah, love that. Okay, I hate to open like someone's PR package without them giving me permission, but I just want to read the ingredients on this. It's sweetened with stevia. It's better than most. And if it's going to help him drink more water and keep him away from eating more, then that's great. I'm just worried if it's spiking his insulin is the only thing, like that would be a no-no. But it's better than him eating a ton of snacks a day. The first ingredient is salt, which makes sense. And I'll have to look up the other ones. There's four ingredients. There's six ingredients. There's salt, citric acid, magnesium malate, potassium chloride, natural flavors, stevia leaf extract. Natural flavors is never a good thing necessarily. I mean, it's better than artificial flavors, but okay, look. This is the only like flavored drink I'll drink, other than like I would do straight alkaline water, lemon water. This is like getting me through the day or workout. It's for an athlete, truly. Anyways, we don't need to get that into it. I have to do more research about it. That's just the truth. Everything that comes into your life, you got to do more research into it. Anyways, I also just love their packaging. And I'm sure there are people that are going to, there's no one going to be watching this. I have an audience of 26 subscribers and barely anyone's watching it. But someone will watch this and they'll come on here and they'll say, actually, that's probably not the best. And look, I'm not saying it's the absolute best, but this is a guy who would literally drink, was drinking like, what's it called? Horrible stuff. He's drinking and eating horrible things. If this is gonna help him stay on track, it's so good. Anyways, you know what? And I'm so tired of, I love this brand so much. I'm like, this with my compression socks is everything this weekend. That is my vibe this weekend. Anyways, so my dad gave the stamp of approval for this, which is rare. He like, it's hard for him to get to like, I don't know, approve of many things. So he's open-minded, but you know, dads can be stuck in their ways. But yeah, so good morning, folks. It is Sunday and super sleepy Sunday. I literally don't even want to do anything. And I may not do anything, but I have some studying to do. And yeah, my brain's just not really there right now. I'm just been so freaking exhausted from the week. And my body literally, it feels so good to just lay and not even leave. And I literally feel like my body is like repairing itself. Because I worked out this week. Like I did as much as my workout routine I could. Like I did my bench press one night. I did just arms another night. I did a full leg workout one night. So yeah, and then on top of that I'm just like standing all day. So yeah, Anyways, it's definitely, it's just been a hard transition for me to go from working out every day to working out like just as much as I can throughout the work week. Yeah, I'm gonna get a coffee and try to get more work done. It's raining. I wanted to use my new compression socks. This is the fit though. Wanted to use my new compression socks, but it is raining and I want to wait until like a dry day to go for a long run. I don't know. And like, obviously there's literally the other side of it where I could just be like, suck it up. Just run in the rain. It doesn't matter. But And I would have, but I genuinely feel like my body is actually benefiting from a rest day. So if it wasn't that case, then I would have just ran. I'm just really excited about my compression socks. Okay. Anyways, I'm gonna enjoy. I also feel like I'm wasting my day because I only have 2 days off if I'm laying in bed. And it's so complicated. It doesn't even have to be that complicated. Okay, I'm making it more complicated than it needs to be. Peace out. Okay, just finished about an 8-mile run. I did about 4 miles north, grabbed a coffee, and 4 miles south. So yeah, I'm gonna do some weights because I've always just gotta remember that muscles are protection against basically atrophy of the body, which happens over time due to so many things, stress, wear and tear, just gravity, just life, right? Anyways, I've got my new sweet ass socks on, the compression socks, and it could be just like a mental thing that happens. The help from like having 6 socks on makes you want to run, but no, like the compression really does help. So yeah, just a little tip from when I was in track in high school. I wore compression socks near the end because all the other girls did. Really fast girls. And it helps. It really does help. I know nurses even wear them. My sister will wear them when she's nursing. So just a little tip there. You can get them online. These ones are really cool. I love the color. It is the most gorgeous day I've ever seen in my life. It really is. And I am doing some of my work on my laptop. And just sitting in the sun, enjoying the beauty of the day. And yeah, super nice to just lay out. And it feels like a day off. Like it actually feels like a day off, which is what I needed. So I'm gonna go grab my pants. They were getting hemmed, my work pants. There was like a hole that's been needing to get fixed. And then I also have these like dad jeans that I'm obsessed with from Urban Outfitters, and like they just fit so perfectly, and there was a hole in them, a huge one, and it was like kind of cool because you could like see, like it's kind of grungy, right? Like you can see the underwear through it, but that's not for me. I definitely wanted to clean it up, so I'll show you how it turned out. I love the lady that I go to. She always has these amazing little snacks, but she always does a really good job. So we'll go check that out. It's just, it feels like better, like stronger than before. These are them. Just like black Levi dad jeans. Obsessed with those, and they're super comfy. Love that. And then my work pants are a Brixton. I'll show you. So basically, there was literally a hole right there in the crotch, of course, but she fixed it. You could never even tell. could never even tell. Yeah, I do love these pants. They're perfect for work. They're black, which I need for work. And then these are just, obviously no jeans allowed at work, but yeah, I've gotten this fixed there and it's still kicking, like, just phenomenal job. All right, that is donezo. Okay, it was a long run day. Now I am finally settling down and making dinner. For dinner, I am doing ground beef and olive oil, avocado oil, really simple, and parsley and cilantro. Basically, there was a ton of parsley and cilantro. First, don't even get me started about, life is so fucking funny. Parsley and cilantro, I'm literally picking off the leaves. I'm gonna show you. Okay, so these were in the fridge and they were just kind of like starting to go bad. So I'm picking off the leaves while I watch my, you know, lessons, whatever YouTube I'm watching, something, maybe even working on schoolwork. I should finish schoolwork. And I've got ground beef in literally just avocado and olive oil. I think I put some garlic powder in there, didn't have to. Oh, and lemon, of course, lemon. And then this is a zucchini salad. I literally just sauteed zucchini on the stove with olive oil. Sweetened it once it was sauteed, sweetened it with honey, and then super simple. I just added almonds, cranberries, and I'm gonna add some feta cheese because it just, they're all healthy fats, really. I'm learning about it right now in school. And I mean, I didn't put a ton of cranberries in there. Dried fruit has benefits, but obviously just be a little, you know, careful with those. And then zucchini has great fats and vitamins and minerals. And then when it comes, we're learning about fats specifically. So, well, first of all, I'm stoked about my beef because just so many benefits to ground beef. Good fats, good everything. But yeah, so like nuts and seeds are good fats, high in omega-3s, high in, basically they're like, what is it? They're unsaturated fats. That's what you want to see. You want to stay away from saturated fats like butter, you know, things that are just textured like butter, vegetable oil, hardened, basically it's hardened oil. That's really what it is. And then things like olive oil, stuff like that. Those are healthy fats. I can get in it another time. I'm still learning too. And so like, you know, you really have to master something to be able to explain it to other people. I am going to add feta cheese to this, and you may say, cheese, what? But cheese is a source of healthy fat and even healthy cholesterol. Cholesterol is in many things, not many things, but a good amount of things. And it's actually like normally occurring. Your body literally produces cholesterol, but that because your body produces cholesterol, you don't need to consume that much. That's really all it is. And if you do, then it has to store it somewhere. And then that's when your it becomes like a plaque, things like that. So basically it's really important to know what your body already naturally makes so that you don't need to consume it. That's really all it is. All right, I'm gonna plate this up and I'll show you what it looks like in the end. Okay, here it is plated. Woo! Got fresh romaine lettuce for the wrap. That's ground beef. Okay, we'll do this. That's ground beef. Tons of greens, like avocado. I put some, it's really funny because my theme at work this week was green for St. Patrick's Day. Anyways, totally besides the point, right? wrap and basically
a salad. I sweetened that with honey. So I added a little bit of sweetener, but literally all I did for sweetener was honey, little bit, and cranberries. So that's the sweetness part of it. And then you've got your feta, just super well-rounded diet. I mean, obviously that's a lot of green. You don't need to have that much green, but I haven't been eating any, and so I like greens. I like the taste of it. It's so good for you. I could go on. It's like, why wouldn't you? But that's fine. Yeah, and then I actually love eating with chopsticks. Maybe because I'm a drummer, but also because I just like having like portion control. It's great for portion control and like mindfully eating. And I also just love the aesthetic of it. Like I just love the simplicity. I just respect like Asian culture so much. And I think there's so much we can learn from, I mean, every culture. But my plate is like low. I don't know, even like what you eat out of, I think plays such an important role about, taking care of your body. I really do. And yeah, I mean, you grow up and you can start making your own choices and your own style and things like that. But, and like what makes you feel clean, make your body feel good. And it's just, this is kind of like the aesthetic I've really loved. I've also got my cilantro and parsley here. I'm literally deflowering these and just gonna save it because they're gonna go bad. Okay. That's that. Plate it up.